Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the ISO-COST method of solving linear programming problems. ISO-COST method is the method of minimizing the cost. As in the isoperfect method, we are given an objective function z equal to ax plus by and we assign an arbitrary chosen fixed value k to this objective function z, and this represents some straight line, and this straight line is called the isocost line. And for different values of the objective function z, we obtain different lines. That is, we obtain a family of isocost lines. Let us consider a linear programming problem to minimize the objective function z equal to 4x plus 6y subject to the constraints given as x plus 2y greater than equal to 18, 3x plus y greater than equal to 75, and the non-negative constraints x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0. So our first step involved in the isocost method to solve this problem is to find the feasible region, and we know that feasible region is the common region which is determined by graphing these constraints. So when we graph all these constraints, we would obtain a common region to all these constraints. That common region would be the feasible region for this problem. This shaded region is the common region determined by the constraints. So this is the feasible region. As you can see, this feasible region is unbounded. And we have also found the point of intersection of these two lines as the point F with coordinates 14 and 33. So we have DFE as the feasible region. And this feasible region is unbounded. Now in the next step, we have the objective function z equal to 4x plus 6y, and we will assign a convenient value to this objective function z. Let z be equal to, that is 4x plus 6y be equal to say 60, which is the common multiple of 4 and 6. We take 4x plus 6y equal to 60. Or you can say 2x plus 3y equal to 30 as equation 1. Now let's graph this equation to get a straight line. So we obtain this line P1, Q1. That is, P1, Q1 represents this equation 1, which is 2x plus 3y equal to 30. Now, since we have that the objective function is of minimization type, so we will draw lines parallel to the line P1, Q1, and we will obtain such a line which is nearest to the origin and has at least one point common to the feasible region. So to draw another line parallel to P1, Q1, we take, let the objective function 4x plus 6y be equal to a constant, say 120, or this equation could be written as 2x plus 3y is equal to 60. Now we'll graph this equation and let this equation be equation number 2. Thus we have obtained a line P2Q2. So we have obtained a line P2Q2 parallel to P1Q1 and the line P2Q2 represents equation 2 and line P2Q2 is drawn parallel to the line P1Q1. So on drawing lines parallel to P1Q1, we obtain a line P3Q3 parallel to P1Q1 such that it has one point, that is the point F, common to the feasible region. So P3Q3 is a line parallel to P1Q1 and is nearest to the origin and also has a point F with coordinates 14, 33 common to the feasible region. Thus, the optimal solution is given by x equal to 14 and y equal to 33, and the optimal value of z is equal to 4 into 14 plus 6 into 33. That is, we substitute x as 14 and y as 33 in the objective function z. This is equal to 56 plus 198, which comes out to be equal to 254. That is, the optimal value of the objective function z is 254. Which is the minimum value in this case. So this is how we solve a linear programming problem using isocost method, and isocost method is used to minimize the cost. Next we discuss the advantages of linear programming problems. As we have already seen, linear programming finds its application in almost all areas of human life. It helps in achieving maximum output maximum profit maximum return on investments and also in evolving least costing transportation routes. Next we discuss the limitations of the linear programming problems. Linear programming can only be applied when the given information can be expressed in terms of linear equations or inequations. And there are several situations in real life when it is not always possible to express the information in the form of linear equations or linear inequations. So in that case, linear programming cannot be applied. And the linear programming techniques are applicable only when all the elements related to a problem can be quantified. That is, the qualitative factors like the human relations, behaviors, credibility, etc. are not taken into account when linear programming techniques are being applied. And sometimes, fractional values are obtained which are irrelevant. Like for example, if we say that 1/4 of a car, and this information is obviously irrelevant, so that is not acceptable. So these are the limitations of linear programming. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the method of isocost of solving linear programming problems and also the advantages and limitations of linear programming.